I don't know from where to start. I'm from Darbhanga district in Bihar. How many of you from Darbhanga here? Sorry, Bihar. And how many of you are engineering background? Quite a few number. Okay. So my story goes like this. I'm the eldest child of my father. My father is a farmer. In class 10th, after class 10th, I dropped my education for 3 months because you don't have enough money to go for the higher education. One of my relative called me one day to my dad and he said, ki, he's good enough, probably let him to continue. So he said, give him the arts paper. But actually I was not interested. So my mother said, ki, whatever, let him to do. And I was in very pathetic position. Like even don't have a 200, 300 rupees a month. Then I took mathematics as a plus two and I cleared the IITJ and state I got to 44, but IIT Guwahati I was getting 7. So I dropped it. That day my father was happy, but I dropped IIT because I was getting 7. Next time I wrote, I was expecting top 10 in IIT. I have never taken coaching, no tuition in plus two. Then after 1 year of drop, suddenly what happened just before the men's examination, IIT men's examination, I cleared the IIT pre. I was a 600 All India pre-rank. Just before men's, I was suffering with jaundice for 3 months. I could not appear in the IIT. That was one biggest setback for me. But I got state rank one, like state CET. Every state has a CET, like Karnataka CET and Bihar CET. That point of time, I don't remember more than 1 lakh students appear in the exam. One of the interview member came and asked me, the junior science preparation science patron, have you heard about that magazine? It comes for the engineering. He asked me, what is the funda for preparing for exam and all that? I said, there is no funda. It's like your hard work and nothing else. Like people go to Kota, Fidji in my time, my cousins and all that. I think they're my uncles are like professors. But none of the people come, you help it out. You have to work out. So getting first rank, I got NIT Trichy. Then that day, I called my teacher. He said, he was 23 rank in IITJ. He suggested me get, and then I got DC, Delhi College of Engineering, All India rank 52. They say DC is not good, go to NIT Trichy is the best. So I think that was my changing moment in my life. I met across the people like different kind of geography. Coming from different places, from the northeast to the Bihar to every places. After 1 year when I went back, one of my cousin asked, what is the difference between an IIT and simple college? And still I say there is no difference apart from the people you find out there. So they have put the hard work, that's the reason they are there. Like syllabus doesn't matter, you win the watch on a Stanford, Harvard, IIT or any college, it doesn't matter. Syllabus are same kind of the books. The people attitude are different. They make your life change. Like you think before that when I was in the rural area preparing for IITJ, still is a very like, never people can think of. But once come like everything is doable. But suddenly what happened, after clearing the BTEC, I was like that point of the time, I was highly paid. Like coming out of, I'm from electronics background. I felt it's okay. That's like, it's good. Because you're like one spectrum. Understanding how the satellite or communication theory works, simple C coding, there's one narrow path. I met one people here, he's my close friend, he's now graduated from, he's a senior manager from Wharton University. How many of you heard about Wharton? It's better than Harvard University. So he graduated from MBA there and we became a friend of him. He's 3 years senior to me, he's an IIT graduate. He said, we started preparing for J, but you know, suddenly what happened? It's a tough syllabus. I dropped the plan. Then I met Keshav sir. And one of my friends, he's a Kiran, he's IPS of UP cadre. He was from IIT also, IIT Chennai, was a 10-pointer. I'm not a 10-pointer, sorry, I'm the 8.6. So we met together, we talk. Sometimes what happened in the industry, if you get highly paid, I become a party guy basically. Even like yesterday night I have a party around 2:30 hour. We converted your life. This is the fact. you get, once your salary cross 20, 25 lakhs plus, you know, no matter what people say, you have to, it's very difficult for preparing for civil services as such. Many of you come across who are the engineers. Like, don't think, what civil services give you the advantage, no matter your success or not. You read history, geography, political science, economics, and your attitude. For me, like, even though I'm not in the source as great, but I think I'm the techie guy, far better than any of the engineer. Just because my thinking, attitude, approach is different. I can, in the geographical term, if you read something, it's very interesting. If you read any novels or any kind of the book, your approach is different. And my optional was math and physics for this examination. So I'm math, physics guy, general study, techie. So it's like, for me, it's like excited. So civil services preparation for me, I cannot tell you how to prepare their teachers, and you know the better than anyone else. The only thing is hard work, and might be you have to miss many party for the engineers guy, but sometime before the exam, it's very difficult. It's very hard to say, no, I don't want to go party, but work hard, because the what you realize down the line, the teachers, the professors, the where you studied, all the text fair from Bhujawala to everyone paid the text for you, because the professor they taught you is the part of the society member, and you come here just because of that text pay. So once you get like, you have to return it back. 2.5 years back, I think I told you, Keshav sir, I got AT&T. Have you heard about 1,10,000 USD, roughly around 60 lakhs package. I called my dad and said, I was in interview, and like, if you came from there, it's like, you know, what, you don't know like what I supposed to do, like your prelims result come in May and after 10 days you have a pre-examination. Then I called my dad, said, isn't 1 lakh is enough in India? Why do you want to go USA? I have no answer. I say, okay, I'll drop it. So prepare for civil services, you learn a lot of things, it's a really excited journey. And when you get success, might be many people will be friend, but the journey, you are the only people you remember that. The night out, so many pages you write, so many new way to write. You read the, like, human geography, climate geography, modern history. Like, it's really excitement, right? Sometime you come in, reading everything. So for me, it was very excited. And like, people really support, like, it is not, it comes to you when you get demotivated. Think about that, what teachers say, what journey is. Like, if journey is not difficult, right, where the people go? Right? This is adventurous. Keshav sir is 99.99%, it's like, you know, might be not get sucked. Think positive. If I get it, fine. If I won't get, who cares? But I try my level best. So at the end of the day, you should not think like, oh, 1% was left, 2% was left. If I have to read this much, I have to clear the paper and all that. No. Do 100%, get it, not get it, get it. And live your life. That's the basic fund up. And really, you have to return it back something to society. Put the hard work. Even I was working, like what's it say, I'm the hardcore R&D engineer. I'm not working in service industry. I'm working in the network, next generation technology. Like, sometimes it's very except hard, putting hard work. Still, I get a time to read magazines. Achha, aaj ke news kya hai? Then I go keep, like, whatever the things I have to left. Pick the paper. Read 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour. There's no fixed rule. You have to study for 10 hour, 15 levels. It's up to your capacity. How much you can do. You can stretch. If you say like, okay, it's boring, leave it. But one dedication, 100%. At the end of the day, you should not regret it. Wherever you want to give the time, give the 100%. Otherwise, better to leave it. There's other lot of things to do that in the life. I don't think this is the only, but this is the one thing you learn a lot, because I go to services, I have people from the, you know, arts background, engineering background, economics background, every background. But in IT, all the techie guy coming from IIT to the, I don't know, some alpha engineering college. So might be, so there is like all kind of the people you find from the different background, different kind of opportunity. Once become a director or a secretary, you have the certain things to change in the life. Might be, don't know, director, secretary and all that, but once you grow, you see like what the people they do. So put the hard work, and really, if you put the hard work, we can do that. That's simple. My background is very simple. When still I look at back, my when I was in 10th, when 3 months I dropped my education because my father has not a 300 rupees per month. No books, I asked the books for my friend, but even though I crack IIT, I got a state first just because of my hard work. And don't set your target, because after civil services, I want to do MBA from Harvard or Wharton. I'll do that. You should not say like, okay, sometime parents say like, okay, ab to ho gaya na, that's enough, you've become an engineer. Oh, you clear the civil services, not enough. What you want from your life, that's important. Tomorrow you want to write a book in quantum physics. Tomorrow you want to write a book in hardcore computer networking. Or tomorrow in the modern history, or India after Gandhi, whatever you want to write. That's the ultimate. Like India's problems is like what I felt in the industry when I get a job, people don't touch the book. Just because of that book you reach it here, after that you don't read the book. They say like, hey, this is not for my syllabus, why the hell I should go and study it? The economics is not my optional. Then you what is IMF, what is bank rate, what is reverse repo rate, CRR, SL, I don't care about that. So you study throughout your life, you can't be a Shashi Tharoor, right? Until you can't be Amad Sain, until unless you not study. So civil services, one thing will give you the platform, will give you the idea about every subjects. And this is really, really amazing stuff. You put the hard work for 1 or 2 years, I hope. Those who really put hard work might be just injustice got ek bar do bar karta hai, then ultimately he'll return you. That's what I can say. Many of you have appeared in this time prelims? All are fresher, is it? You have appeared. Okay, how many of you have cleared before prelims examination? No. So, I don't know how to say from my background, I said it's engineering background. My optional was math and physics. And for preparing for civil services, in beginning what I felt that some subject like those who are from arts background, for them it's very difficult to go through science papers. And those who are from engineering background, for them it's a history, ancient, medieval, modern and geography. After 10th they want to study. So it is really difficult in beginning, like how to handle that, how to start reading. Like if you pick up the Constitution of India book, people say go to this author, some say Didi Basu, some say Lakshmikant, some say Subhash Kashyap, or it doesn't matter. And sometime for modern history you refer many books. The next question comes like book selection. Some people say what optional I have to take. From this year there is only one optional. GS is very important. So optional decision. Second, next part is like people say like, okay, what to study and what not to study. So these are the very, very difficult questions. What I have to say, if you pick up the civil services, I hope you are matured enough. Because if you think like it's easy, please forget that. You have many other services for you. If you want to be in the state services or like in the banking or in the continue the whatever, you are the doctor, engineer or MBA grads, it doesn't matter. If you want to come to the services, you have to fight with the IIT guy, maybe from All India Medical Science, IIM guys, and like St. Stephen or like the Delhi University, Anna University or top class from any university. States are very few. It's a game, it's like very difficult. Sometimes people say like, I know many of my friends, all my 5 roommates, one is UP Cadre IS, one is Andhra Cadre IPS, I am IFS, 2 in IRS. All my 5 roommates are clear. It's like people say like teachers is important, yes. Friends is important, yes. So kind of optional selection is yes. Hard work is of course is very tough, yeah, it's true. But in civil services, one more important parameter is dedication. Like if you start preparing, I'm damn sure like many people clear the prelims, mens and UREs. I've been there twice in interview. Like you clear the prelims, you win the mens, that point of the time is start in October. Waiting for the mens result will come in the month of February or March first week. You've been through interview in April, first week is the final result. And then third or second with the prelims, and you failed. Like, then you say like, what I supposed to do and what not supposed. Many people say like, leave it here. I don't have anything. The people don't have any other option. They say okay, next year. That's how they proceed. So for me, like even I failed twice. I say I initially thought to give up. I drop in between. Like I was like say like. I've been twice in the interview, I think it's very difficult for me to crack. Once I got very less in interview and one time very less in mens. And I said after 1 year I recovered it somehow. And they said, no, I have to fight it back. People suggested me go to the public administration, change your math or physics because it's a very scaling paper. Have you heard about there is a huge scaling in civil services? Might be no. It's like left and right scaling. So this time I'm the single guy who cleared with math and physics combined. There's 6 from mathematics, 8 from physics, but I'm the single one who cleared from math and physics background. In 2010 batch, Sambu, who was my roommate, who was from math and physics, he got 42 rank. He's a UP cadre, he's in SDM charge. He's a Durga Sakti Nagar batch. So like he was the single guy. So for him also, he cleared from IIT and went there, and they say like he selected a wrong option. He has to change it. But once you decide, I said, like you have to stick with that. Initially, you have to give a lot of thoughts, what optional you need to pick, and prepared accordingly. And for the GS part, like 2009 batch, I was like, I scored, any people know about 2009, how was the GS marks they have given, average was 230. I got 340 marks. I used that one of that ranger in the GS marks. So even though I'm not from the arts background, what I notice is like when you read history as a modern history, like after 1857, my technique is entirely different. I read like, okay, for like, what is the administration reform happen? What is the economic reform? What is the economic condition? What is the social condition since independence? Since 1857. So if you read in that and then kind of the hero, those who are called freedom struggle hero, these are the philosopher, how they have contributed it. Prepare the notes accordingly. And for geography, I don't know how difficult it is, but I have a 1.5 page notes. I think you don't believe it. Coaching Leong book, have you heard about that? Coaching Leong is a geography book. I have 1.5 page notes. I prepared in 2009. And after that, I have never ever read geography. That's the end of the story. You know, from like the, what is the factor, like, you know, equator to the, then ITCZ, then Himalaya, then Western Ghat, then Eastern Ghat. And you know the how the rain pattern, you know the forest, you know the forest area, you know economic condition, you know economic condition, then you can say human settlement pattern. After human settlement pattern, you know what kind of the administration, how the people works. All are interconnected, but you have to get the clue. Like if you draw the India map, equator is passing to ITC, then intertropical cancer of zone. Then when Coriolis force, how the wind get happen, what is the role of Western Ghat, Eastern Ghat, Tibet, and what is the rainfall pattern. So this you need to prepare. If you took the book of Constitution of India, people, many people say, hey, I know Article 52 or Article 57 or some article. Might be say this guy remember a lot of things. But I don't think that really it's helpful. If you can remember, it's really good. Even you cannot, you understand the concept. People say like, you know, finance bill, the people say it's amendment, amendment bill, people say it's like, you know, general bill, or they say fundamental duty, fundamental rights, they say some power of the Supreme Court. You just understand the concept. And you write the concept somewhere in your paper, because before the examination, what I felt, I was working, I didn't get the time. I have 3 hour, 2 hour, 4 hour, whatever I have. I can't go to the book. I can't underline every, like, you know, you can go through it. So I have a small notes in my own language. So I revise that before the examination. And whenever you write in the examination, I never attempted 600 out of 600 in my life. In GS also, people say I attempted 270, 260. I used to attempt 230, 240, even though I managed 160, 170. That was my, people score even 300, a dump at 80 marks and 90 marks. There is a difference when you start anything. First you understand the question. What, how, people say, question is elucidate, describe it, explain it. There are differences. If you explain it, what you have to write. Elucidate it, what you have to write. Justify it. If they say justify, it is a, doesn't mean that you go and without writing the background of the question and then you putting the point. People say like, you assume that examiner know. Word limitation, just give the introduction of that, what you understood, and then justify it, the background. So that's the way people face the marks. I don't know, I'm the lucky enough or whatever, say, this is the way I approach. And I used to do a lot of practice before examination. You write a questions, pick any questions, random questions, last 10-year question papers, and write it. And you ask your friend, does it something missing here? If you have a group, like all my five friends, like we share the question paper, like, okay, is it good or is it bad? I give the credit to one of my senior, he was third rank in civil service, Rande. He was my senior as well in the college. What he got third rank in fourth attempt. And for him, what he used to say, right, UPSC you can get in 500, 400, 300 ranks, but cracking within 50, you need a lot of practice. You have to mug up many facts, and your presentation should be good. And top of that, interview also matters, because I was the guy, engineering services, how many people heard about the IES? Yeah, I cleared the IES, but I didn't join that. And I was the top one in Indian engineering services. So when I enter into the room in India, that it's a very pure technical. I'm very techy guy, no matter what the question asks, I feel comfortable enough. With the five Buddha over they sit, right? I'm able to answer them at least. But when I enter into the IFS interview, the first question he asked, when I enter, the moment he asked, like, what Yahoo stands for, before sitting into the chair, and he asked me what the Yahoo stands for. And might be for you, generally, I was started a long time back reading computer science and all. So for me, yet another hierarchy of, might be they ask Google what does it stand for, might be I'm not able to answer. But Yahoo, I was like somehow. Then say what computer virus stand for. So I say vital information resource analysis. You can't believe that. He asked me the definition of what is called a resource. And it was 4-minute long interview, define what is called a resource, and what is information and what kind of information and what is vital means. It's not a dictionary meaning, but what you perceive. Their body language, your politeness, their humbleness, they perceive in that manner. Then they come to, they ask me, like, I've been in Karnataka for so many years, and here the first question, how many districts comes in the coastal area of Karnataka? So I named them 3-4, and then 2-3 I named. And then I think one guy was, he's a vice chancellor, I think, some university. Later on, I check his background. He was related to Karnataka only. So I said, 2 districts, and they say, you don't know, like, then I've been BTEC from NIT Trichy. Trichy is an international airport. But he asked me the question, why there is no domestic flight takeoff from there? And I don't have the answer, seriously. And I give the funda because people in Tamil, they stayed in Sri Lanka, the people fly in the Gulf and all that. So they're not happy with that answer. When come to what is the economic crisis happening from 2008, what do you expect after 10 years where the economy goes? They're just speculating. Then comes to the Naxal issue. Then was question related to women empowerment in Bihar. Nitish Kumar government, what did in last 10 years for the women empowerment? So I was in from a state, I just marked up like what are the policy they have done for this. So interview is also sometimes important. And you have to be humble because this five Buddha is very crucial because that is, you don't know, you have to be very, very polite. Even you don't know, one question somebody asked me, what is the difference between image and picture? That was one question because I'm from electronics background. Few of the question comes from what is the difference between image and picture. It's a very common question, right? And that was 3-4 minutes it took. How the image is stored. When you click the camera, what are the processing happen? What form they store in the megapixel? And what is people say resolution, what does it mean? And how exactly got stored in the one of that? And normal camera, what are the differences? So interview the general things, whatever you study, it's 275 marks. Before that it was 300 in my time. When 2012 I batch, it is 300. So interview is also very, very crucial. So for civil services examination, what I felt, book, following the discipline, read chapter by chapter, look at the previous year question paper, on top of that you write it down. Once you start writing, right, you feel your weakness, what you are missing, where are you missing, and for any subject, like you write the international issue or bilateral relationship or social issue, write it down, how much you can write it. If you write 10, 20, 30 questions, that's enough.
or 50 questions as much as you can do. But before, without writing that, it's very difficult to get within top 50. It's very, very difficult to get within 50. Or we might be teachers or the guidelines. They'll tell you this book you have to read, because teachers have the contact of the many, the successful candidate and the failure candidates. They met people across the spectrum, like from the top to the bottom. They'll tell you what is the weaknesses. And for civil services, I think it's a student is a main factor, 90%. Teacher is important for the guidelines. Sometimes you're reading something unnecessary, they said like, I don't think so it is worth. You follow these guidelines, you follow these guidelines. And selection, the optional paper, it's a depend on the availability of the materials and your passion about that. So I think like it's open flow question, you people ask, then probably I can answer.
Sir, maybe this one, whatever I have heard in Delhi and Bangalore.
Okay.
Many candidates are failing during the exam. Are there for many candidates failing during the exam? There are less failing during the exam. Why?
Okay. In preliminary examination paper 2, what engineers think, like they become a pseudo-intellectual. They say like paper 2 him is very easy, but it's a bad perception. You can score 130 or 140 in paper 2, try to score 170 or 160. And paper 1, it's a normal paper. So why people fail, I generally, they take paper 2, mathematics paper as a like, you know, guarantee. And they fail to score even 120 also. And paper 1, they dump around 90, their total score 210. I don't know what is the cutoff this time, my total score is 267. And paper 2 for me around 167 or 157. So if you like, if you're not, like 120 and 167,